chapter 5. Genesis chapter 5. I read. This is the book of the generations of Adam. In the day that God created man, in the likeness of God, made he him. Male and female created he them, and blessed them, and called their name Adam. In the day when they were created, and Adam lived 130 years and begat a son in his own likeness after his image, and called his name Seth. And the day of Adam, after he had begotten Seth, were 800 years, and he begat sons and daughters. And all the days of that Adam lived were 930 years, and he died. And Seth lived 105 years, and begat Enos. And Seth lived after he begat Enos 807 years, and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Seth were 912 years, and he died. And Enos lived 90 years and begat Canaan. And Enoch lives after he begat Canaan 850 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Enos were 905 years, and he died. And Canaan lived 70 years and begat Mahalalel. And Canaan lived after he begat Mahalalel 840 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Canaan were 910 years, and he died. And Mahalalel lived 65 years and begat Jared. And Mahalalel lived after he begat Jared 830 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Mahalalel were 895 years, and he died. And Jared lived 166 years, and he begat Enoch. And Jared lived after he begat Enoch 800 years, and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Jared were 962 years, and he died. And Enoch lived 60 years and begat Methuselah. And Enoch walked with God after he begat Methuselah 300 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Enoch were 365 years, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. And Methuselah lived 180 years and 7 years, 187 years, and begat Lamech. And Methuselah lived after he begat Lamech 782 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Methuselah were 969 years, and he died. And Lamech lived 182 years and begat a son, and he called his name Noah, saying, "These same shall comfort us concerning our work and toil and our hands, because of the ground which Yahweh had cursed." And Lamech lived after he begat Noah 595 years and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Lamech were 777 years, and he died. And Noah was 500 years old, and Noah begat Shem and Ham and Japheth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise our Almighty Father Yahweh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Adam to Noah. From Adam to now, Noah. Genesis 5 verses 1 to 5. Adam and Seth, verse 1. Here begins a second genealogy. The first is Genesis 4, 7 to 25. The genealogy of Cain. This fifth chapter is the list of 10 descendants of Adam to Noah. The technique of mixing narrative and genealogy is found throughout the book of Genesis. A primary purpose seems to be to show the development of the human race from Adam to Noah and to bridge the gap in the time between the two. Here are three important remarks to keep in mind about scriptural genealogy. First, genealogies. Yahshua invites Christ followers to focus on their faith rather than fables and genealogies. I quote the following three scriptures. And think not to say within yourself, we have Abraham to our father. For I say to you that God is able of these stones to raise up children to Abraham. End of quote. This is Matthew 3 verse 9. Therefore, link to a father is not physical blood, but spiritual fellowship. I quote the next scripture, neither give heed to fables and endless genealogy, which minister questions rather than godly edifying, which is in faith. So do. End of quote. This is 1 Timothy 1 verse 4. The next quotation is, I quote, but avoid foolish questions and genealogies and contentions and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and vain. End of quote. This is Titus 3 verse 9. Second, time measure. Most interpreters view the years mentioned in this chapter based on the human counting of 12 months for a year, 365 days for a year. Yet God's year is not man's year. For the scripture says, I quote, For the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like a day. End of quote. This is quoting 2 Peter 3 verse 8 and Psalm 90 verse 4. In addition, divine laws of nature are in conflict with the possibility of a human being living hundreds of years. Third, Father. Father is a name applied first to any ancestors, like in Deuteronomy 1 verse 11, 1 Kings 15 verse 11, Matthew 3 verse 9, Matthew 23 verse 30, and so on. second to, as a title of respect to a chief, a ruler, or an elder, and any other hierarchy, as it is said in Judges 17 verse 10, Judges 18 verse 19, 1 Samuel 10 verse 12, 2 Kings 2 verse 12, and Matthew 23 verse 9, and many others. And third, as the author or the beginner, we may say a founder of anything. Jabal and Jubal in Genesis 4, verses 20 to 21 are the authors or the beginners or the founders of cultures or beliefs. The beliefs of, I quote, those who live in tents and raise livestock. For the first one, the second, Jubal, of all, I quote, who play stringed instruments and pipes, end of quote, for the other. Therefore, spiritual patriarchs can rightly be viewed as the founders of early beliefs, doctrines, religions, or churches. Adam was made in the image of Yahweh, but when fallen, he begot a son in his own image, which is sinful and defiled, frail, wretched, and mortal like himself. Not only a man like himself, consisting of body and soul and spirit, but a sinner like himself. This was the reverse of that divine likeness in which Adam was made. Having lost it, he could not convey it to his seed. Adam lived in all 330 years, which can be interpreted as his religion or doctrine, having reigned that amount of time. And also remember that each day of these 930 years, you shall be due time 1,000 to convert it in our present time. And then he or it died according to the sentence passed upon him. I quote, "To dust thou shalt return," end of quote. So he did not die in the day he ate forbidden fruit, yet in that very day he became mortal. Then he began to die. His whole life after was but a reprieve, a forfeited, condemned life. It was a wasting, dying life. Man's life is but dying by degrees. Genesis 5 verses 6 to 20. The patriarch from Seth to Enoch. Concerning each of these, except Enoch, it is said, I quote, "And he died," end of quote. It is well to observe the death of others, they and their doctrines or religions or churches all lived very long. Not one of them died till he had seen almost 800 years. And some of them lived much longer, a great while, for an immortal soul to be imprisoned in a house of clay. When interpreted as humans, the present life surely was not to them such a burden as it commonly is now. Else, they would have been weary of it Nor was the future life so clearly revealed to them as it now is under the gospel. Else they would have been urgent to depart from it. All the patriarchs that lived before the flood, except Noah, were born before Adam died. They were born when Adam was still alive. When patriarchs are seen as many religions, this means the basis of their doctrines was Adam's. From him they might receive a full account of the creation, the fall, the promise, and the divine precepts about religious worship and a religious life. Thus Yahweh kept up in his church the knowledge of his will. Remember, the branch of Seth is the branch of the descendants that feared Yahweh, because the branch of Cain is the branch of those who did not fear Yahweh, those who lived in the world and were concerned only about the things of the world. Genesis 5 verses 21 to 24, Enoch is the centerpiece in his genealogy. The phrase, I quote, walked with God, end of quote, is only used in two men, Enoch and Noah, in Genesis 5 verses verse 22 and Genesis 6 verse 9. This further confirms our belief that the name father in genealogies refers to the beginner or author or founder of a religion or doctrine. And Enoch and Noah are presented as those whose religion was the belief in Yahweh. For walk is a biblical figure for fellowship and obedience that results in divine blessing. It describes the closest communion with Yahweh as if walking at his side. Enoch was the seventh from Adam. Godliness is walking with Yahweh, which shows reconciliation to Yahweh. For two cannot walk together except they agree, as it is said in Amos 3 verse 3. Godliness includes all the parts of a godly, righteous, and sober life. To walk with Yahweh is to set Yahweh always before us, to act as always under his eyes. It is constantly to care in all things to please Yahweh and in nothing to offend him. It is to be follower of him as dear's children do. The Holy Spirit, instead of saying, Enoch lived, he says, Enoch walked with Yahweh. This was his constant care and work, while other fathers in the genealogy lived to themselves and the world according to their religions and doctrines. He lived to Yahweh. It was the joy of his life. Enoch was removed to a better world, like Prophet Elijah, who was also taken up to heaven. He ascended to heaven, as we can see it in 2 Kings 2. As he did not live like the rest of mankind, so he did not live. He did not leave the world by death as they did. He was not found because Yahweh had translated him, has ascended him. I quote, by faith, Enoch was taken from this life so that he did not experience death. He could not be found because God has taken him away. For before he was taken, he was condemned as one who pleased the God. End of quote. This is said in Hebrews 11 verse 20. The Hebrews 11 verse 5. Enoch has lived but 365 years, which certainly refers to the duration of his religion or church. Yahweh often takes soonest those whom he loves best. The time they lose on earth is gained in heaven to their unspeakable advantage. For Yahweh had a solution against the fallen angels and demons, whom Enoch described as the cause of the wickedness of his day's mankind. Enoch's teachings and revelations can be found in the apocryphal, that means they are not included in the Bible. The apocryphal book of Enoch, which includes the following sections: Enoch's journey through the earth and Sheol, which is also called Hades, the realm, the kingdom of the dead; the parables, a fragment; the book of the courses of the heavenly luminaries; the dream vision, the concluding section, and a fragment of the book of Noah. See how Enoch's removal is expressed. He was not, for Yahweh took him. He was not any longer in this world. He was changed. He was changed as the saints shall be, who are alive at Christ's second coming. Those who begin to walk with Yahweh when young may expect to walk with him long, comfortably, and usefully. The true Christ followers steady walk in holiness through many years till Yahweh takes him or her will best recommend the religion that many oppose and many abuse. And walking with Yahweh well agrees with the cares, comforts, and duties of life. Genesis 5 verses 25 to 32. Metuselah to Noah. Metuselah signifies he dies, or there is a dot, or a sending forth, namely of the deluge, which came the year that Methuselah died. He or his religion lived 969 years, the longest that any organization ever lived on earth before. But the longest liver must die at last. Noah signifies comfort, long-lived, or repose. His parents gave him that name with a prospect of his being a great blessing to his generation. Observe his father's complaint of the calamitous state of human life, but the entrance of sin and the curse of sin. Our whole life is spent in labor, and our time filled up with continual toil. Yahweh, having cursed the ground, it is as much as some can do with the utmost care and pains to get a hard livelihood comfort us. It signifies not only that desire and expectation that parents generally have about their children, that they will be comforts to them and helpers, though they often prove otherwise, but it signifies also a prospect of something more. Is Christ ours? Is heaven ours? We need better comforters under our toil and sorrow than the dearest relations and the most promising offspring. May we seek and find comfort in Christ. Know this, and the Lord Yahweh will bless you. Amen. Hallelujah.